创世纪从十二章到五十章在描写世代 的人。
And from chapter 12 through chapter 50, it describes four generations.
就是亚伯兰、以撒、雅各、约瑟。
There's Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, and Joseph.
那这四代人、都是非常有信心的。
And these four generations of people, they have great faith.
所以在他们生活当中、对神的体验、对神的带领的、体验非常丰富。
So that throughout their life, they had a lot of experience of God's guidance.
今天我们拜的神跟他们拜的神是同一位。
And today, the God we worship is the same God that they worshipped.
所以我们的信仰生活需要信心。
So within our daily lives, we need faith.
当我们一谈到信心、常常我们跟神迹奇事连在一起。
And oftentimes when we talk about faith, we associate it with miracles.
不错，神迹奇事需要信心。
It's true that miracles and signs require faith.
但是、当一个人生活很平安、很顺利、他不需要神迹奇的时候，他也需要信心。
But when life is smooth and you're living in peace, you also need faith.
所以这四代人，我们看他们信心的表现不太一样。
So we can see how the faith of these four generations of people, their faith seems a little different.
亚伯兰的信心就是往前看。
For Abraham, his faith makes him look forward.
神应许给他一块、地。
God promised him a piece of land.
他没有看过那一块地。
He has not seen that piece of land.
他相信神，他就离开他的本地，就往那个地方去。
But because he believed in God, he... picked up his family and moved.
那后来、神应许给他一个儿子。
And afterwards, God promised him a son.
他从75岁一直等到快到100岁。
And from the age of 75, he kept on waiting till he was 100 years old.
虽然中间有一点软弱，但是到最后他得到神应许给他那个儿子。
And even though in the midst of that, he had a moment of weakness, in the end, he still received that promise son that God was going to give him.
但是到了他的儿子以撒，信心的表现就不太一样。
And his son Isaac, the manifestation of his faith was also different.
以撒的一生，我们可以看出他是一个非常顺服的。
And we can see that Isaac lived a very submissive life.
那顺服需要有很大的信心。
And it requires a lot of faith to be submissive.
比方说、在、娶太太这件事情。
In the matter of him marrying his wife.
他愿意顺服父亲的安排，顺服老仆人的、替他的努力。
He was submissive towards the arrangement of his father as well as the wife that this old servant found him.
当然，亚伯兰是一个属灵人。
And Abraham was a person of spiritual faith.
那这个老仆人也是敬畏神的人。
And this old servant was someone who also revered God.
所以他有这个信心，他就得神祝福，跟着利百加结婚。
And Isaac, because he believed in God, he was blessed by God, and he married Rebecca.
那他在遇到饥荒的时候
，And in times of famine,
他想要搬家
，He wanted to move.
但是神跟他讲，你不要搬。
But God told him, don't move.
那不要搬，每一天生活都很困难。
But by staying there, each day is very difficult.
但是他有信心，他就顺服神。
But because he had faith, he was submissive towards God.
结果第二年就有100倍的收成。
But then in the second year, his crops had 100 folds.
所以这种顺服、是信心的表现。
So that his submissiveness is a manifestation of his faith.
今天记载圣经里面每一句话都是有能力的。
And today in the Bible, the words of the Bible has power.
我们读了，我们知道，但是我们有没有办法顺服
？We've read it and we know it, but are we able to be submissive towards it？
如果我们愿意顺服，我们生活会有很多的体验。
If we're willing to be submissive to the words of God, then we will have a lot of experience in our lives.
那以撒有两个儿子
，Isaac has two sons，
一个是以扫，一个是雅各。
One is Esau, the other is Jacob.
那雅各也是有信心的。
Jacob also had faith.
我们来看雅各的信心是 什么。
So let's look at the faith of Jacob.
首先我们回来看创世纪的二十八章。
So let's turn to the book of Genesis, chapter 28.
创世纪的二十八章。
Genesis, chapter 28.
二十八章的十五节。
Chapter 28, verse 15.
创世纪二十八章十五节。
Genesis chapter 28, verse 15. Behold, I am with you, and will keep you wherever you go, and will bring you back to this land, for I will not leave you until I have done what I have spoken to you.
十六节。
Verse 16. Then Jacob awoke from his sleep and said, Surely the Lord is in this place, and I did not know it.
这个地方哈、记载雅各在睡觉的时候看见一件事情。
And this records a dream of Jacob.
他看见有个梯子通到天上去。
In his dream, he saw a ladder that goes up to heaven.
然后神的使者在梯子上上下下。
And the angel of God goes up and down on this ladder.
然后到十三节哈、神自我介绍，我是你主亚伯兰的神，也是以撒的神。
And then in verse 13, God introduced himself to him, saying, I'm the Lord God of Abraham, your father, and the God of Isaac.
然后接下去神对他一个应许，也是一个祝福。
And then God gave him a promise as well as a blessing.
我要将你躺卧之地赐给你，你跟你的后裔。
The land on which you lie, I will give to you and your descendants.
然后到十五节。
And continuing on to verse 15.
我要与你同在。
I am with you.
这句话神也对以撒讲过，我要与你同在。
The same phrase God also spoke to Isaac before.
然后你无论往哪里去，我要保佑你。
And will keep you wherever you go.
然后我要领你归回这地，我不离开你。
And will bring you back to this land, for I will not leave you.
然后我要成全向你所应许的。
And I will do what I have spoken to you.
所以在梦中神向他显现，告诉他神是谁，给他应许，给他祝福。
So in Jacob's dream, God appeared to him, introducing himself and bless him and promise him.
那这个雅各一醒起来他说，如果我们看刚刚读十六节神在这里，我竟然不知道。
And when Jacob awoke in verse 16, he said, Surely God is in this place, and I did not know it.
所以有时候我们信主久的觉得神是在天国。
And sometimes we have believed in the Lord for so long that we think that God is in heaven.
有时候我们就觉得神就在教会。
Or we think that God is in church.
那以撒在旷野只有一个人。
And when Jacob was in the desert, there was just him.
他以为只有他一个人。
He thought he was all by himself.
但是这个体验让他知道神竟然在这里，我竟然不知道。
But with this experience, he realized that God was with him there, and he didn't know it.
那后来他就到了十八节他就把他立一个石头，然后起名叫伯特利。
And in verse 18, when he arose, he took a stone that he had put on his head, set it up as a pillar, and named that place Bethel.
那为什么雅各会跑到旷野去？
And why would Jacob go to this place, a desert?
因为他的人生遇到一个极大的困难。
Because he faced a challenge, a difficulty in his life.
因为他的哥哥以扫要杀他。
Because his brother Esau wanted to kill him.
那哥哥要杀你，你怎么办？你只有逃啊。
And what can you do if your brother wants to kill you? You can only flee.
然后他的妈妈也建议他，你到我弟弟那拉班那里去，等到你哥哥恨消了，我再叫你回来。
And his mother also tell him to go to his uncle Laban, and she said that I'll call you back when your brother is not angry anymore.
他的爸爸以撒也说，你到拉班的家去娶一个太太。
And his father Isaac also told him, go to your uncle Laban and get married there.
所以为什么雅各要搬家？
So why did Jacob need to move?
不是他选择要搬家。
It's not that he wanted to.
啊，是他的人生遇到一个重大的困难，他不得不搬家。
But rather he faced a huge difficulty in his life, and with no choice, he had to move.
好，那我们就在想，那神既然应许啊要跟他同在，要带他回来，那为什么神就不跟他讲，你不需要搬了，你就住在这里，我要跟你同在，我要祝福你。
And we can ponder upon this. How come, since God is with him, why don't God just tell him that, oh, you don't need to move, you could just stay here and I'll bless you?
啊，我们就仔细看啊，因为雅各的一生做了一件错误的事情。
And we could see that Jacob throughout his life, he did one major wrong.
啊，因为这件事情，他哥哥想要杀他。
And because of this wrong deed, his brother wanted to kill him.
啊，所以他不得已啊，他要对自己的错误做一个负责，就是他要离开。
And as a consequence, he needed to leave.
好，那我们就想啊，雅各到底做了什么错事？
So let's think about it. What wrong did Jacob do?
当然，从以撒来看哦，雅各错了两次。
From the viewpoint of Isaac, Jacob did two things.
以撒啊。
From the viewpoint of Esau, Jacob did two things wrong.
但是我们大家来想想看，是不是他真的错两次
？But let's consider, did he really do things wrong two times?
好，我们先来看啊，创世纪的二十七章。
Let's first turn to Genesis chapter 27.
创世纪二十七章的三十六节。
Chapter 27, verse
36. 啊，请读。
And Esau said, "Is he not rightly named Jacob? For he has supplanted me these two times. He took away my birthright, and now look, he has taken away my blessings." And he said, "Have you not reserved a blessing for me?"
好，这里啊，他的哥哥以扫说，他的名字叫做雅各，不是对的吗
？And his brother said, "Is he not rightly named Jacob?"
哦，那雅各什么意思
？What does the name Jacob mean?
雅各就是抓住，他看到好的，他看到机会，他就要抓住。
Jacob means to grab, and whenever he sees an opportunity, he grabs it.
哦，那对以扫来讲哦，他错了两次，就是因为他想要抓住，所以错了两次。
And from the perspective of Esau, he thinks that Jacob did it wronged him two times.
那第一次错在哪里
？And what was the first time?
啊，以扫说他夺了我长子的名分。
Here Esau said he took away my birthright.
啊，所以以扫觉得雅各是错的，他夺了他长子的名分。
So Esau think that Jacob wronged him by taking away his birthright.
啊，但是如果我们再回到前面来看
，But if we look back in the Bible,
啊，真的以扫夺了雅各夺了以扫的长子名分吗
Did Jacob grab and took away Esau's birthright?
我们回到二十六章啊，二十五章来看。
Let's look at chapter
25. 啊，我们看二十六章的二十九节。
二十五章二十九节
啊。
Chapter 25, verse 29. Now Jacob cooked a stew, and Esau came in from the field, and he was weary.
啊，三十节。
Verse 30. And Esau said to Jacob, "Please feed me with the same red stew, for I am weary." Therefore, his name was called Edom.
好，三十一节。
Verse 31. But Jacob said, "Sell me your birthright as of this day."
好，三十二节。
Verse 32. And Esau said, "Look, I'm about to die. So what is this birthright to me?"
好，这个地方讲啊，在二十九节。
And in this passage in verse 29, it reports.
雅各在煮红豆汤了哈。
Jacob was cooking a stew.
然后以扫从田间回来累昏了。
And Esau came in from the field and he was weary.
人一旦累昏了人的判断就会错误。
He was weary and famished, and in that state, he made a wrong decision.
然后他肚子很饿他就对雅各说。你把这个红汤给我。
He was famished, and he said to Jacob, "Please feed me with the same red stew."
然后雅各说，我可以给你喝啊，但是有一个代价。
And Jacob said, "Yes, I can give you the stew, but there's a price to it."
所以三十一节你今日长子的名分卖给我。
In verse 31, Jacob said, "Sell me your birthright as of this day."
所以对雅各来讲啊, 肚子饿一点没有关系, 我可以再煮一次, 但是啊, 这个长子的名分比较重要。
But for Jacob, he's willing to give up his right stew because the birthright seemed more important to him.
所以我可以用这一碗汤跟你换长子的名分。
So he was willing to exchange the red stew for the birthright.
好，那我们接下去看啊，以扫怎么说。
And let's look at what Esau said.
以扫说：“我要死，这长子的名分对我什么益处呢？”
Esau said, "Look, I'm about to die. So what is this birthright to me?"
哦，这个我要死啊！这是没有信的人跟信的人对人生的结论都一样。 我们每一个人都会死。
So he said he's about to die, and death is something that happens to believers as well as unbelievers.
但是相同的结论推出两种不同生活方式。
Even though all of us face death at some point, but the way we live our life is different.
因为以扫说我要死啊，那死了就完了，长子名分没有用啊，但是我现在这一碗汤喝下去，我马上就得到舒服，得到满足。
Because to Esau, he's about to die, then the birthright doesn't have anything beneficial to him, but so he'd rather have the food now.
所以如果我们看前面的描写，很显然，雅各是在以扫的同意之下交换了长子的名分。
So based on this passage, we can see that Jacob gained the birthright under the agreement with Esau.
所以他有没有骗雅，骗以扫呢？ 应该是没有。
So it doesn't seem like Jacob deceived Esau here.
好，那我们现在就在想，这个长子的名分到底什么？为什么雅各这么看重？
So what is this birthright that Jacob would put so much emphasis on it?
好，现在我们看希伯来书。
Let's look at the book of Hebrews.
希伯来书的12章。
Hebrews chapter 12.
希伯来书的12章。
Hebrews chapter 12.
22节。
Verse 22.
请。
But you have come to Mount Zion and to the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem, to an innumerable company of angels.
12章23节。
Verse 23. To the general assembly and church of the firstborn who are registered in heaven to God the judge of all, to the spirits of just men made perfect.
24节。
Verse 24, to Jesus the mediator of the new covenant and to the blood of sprinkling that speaks better things than that of Abel.
这个22节讲，你们来到锡安山是永生神的诚意，是天上的耶路撒冷。
In verse 22, it says that you have come to Mount Zion into the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem.
这个是什么?
What is this?
如果再深入看去，这个就是教会。
If you look into it, this is the church.
教会是天上降下来的圣城，新耶路撒冷。
Church is the new city that descended from heaven.
那教会是永生神的诚意。
And the church is also the city of the living God.
那这个永生的诚意里面有什么?
And what is in this living city?
有审判众人的神。
There's God who judges all.
再来前面有千万的天使。
And in the passages also said, an innumerable company of angels.
23节,有名录在天上诸长子之会。 义人的会,
and the general assembly and church of the firstborn who are registered in heaven.
那这个被成全之人的灵魂是谁?
And who are these?
就是,
the spirits.
就是我们每一个人。
Just all of us.
所以那个长子的名分今天就是指着每一个信耶稣他的罪蒙宝血洁净这一群人在神看起来就他就是有长子的名分。
So the status of the firstborn is given to those who are baptized into Jesus, who have this sonship.
那这个长子的名分有什么宝贵?
So what's so precious about this status of being firstborn?
如果我们看彼得前书的第二章。
If we turn to 1 Peter chapter 2.
第二章的第九节。
chapter 2, verse 9.
啊，彼得前书二章九节。
First Peter chapter 2, verse 9.
啊，请。
But you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, his own special people, that you may proclaim the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light.
啊，这个被神拣选啊，进到这个永生的城啊，在第二章的第九节哈啊，这里描写他的尊贵性。
And for the people who are chosen to be able to enter into the city, verse 9 talks about how precious this is.
他是被拣选的族类。
You are a chosen generation.
所以他是特别蒙神所爱的。
So it's loved by God.
啊，被拣选本身就是神的爱。
And to be chosen by God, this is the love of God.
不是我们的行为去换来的。
It's not that something we did that we exchanged for this.
没有一个人行为能够达到神的标准。
No one can perform to a standard that's good enough.
我们都是不配的。
We're all unworthy.
那不配，为什么神拣选我们？
Then why did God choose us?
因为他爱我们。
It's because he loves us.
啊，再来，我们是君尊的祭司。
Here it says that we're a royal priesthood.
我们是罪人。
We were sinners.
但是我们今天竟然能够站在圣洁的神面前来奉献我们的祷告，来敬拜神。
But then now today we're able to come before God to pray and worship Him.
因为神给我们尊贵的身份，好像祭司一样。
It is because God has given us this honorable status, a royal priesthood.
我们是圣洁的国度。
A holy nation.
我们都是蒙恩的罪人。
We are all sinners who were saved by grace.
但是我在神的宝血之下，我们变圣洁，所以神跟我们同在啊，神与我们在一起。
But under the washing away of our sins, we became a holy nation, and God is with us.
我们是属神的子民。
We are His own special people.
所以今天这个长子的名分，就是我们得到救恩以后神要给我们的这诸般的福气。
So the status of the firstborn is all of these blessings that God has in store for us.
那以撒生的这个两个儿子，他们对长子的名分的看法就不一样。
So for Esau's two sons, the two sons have different perspective on this sonship.
以扫说我会死，所以这个没有用了。
Esau said, "Well, I'm about to die. What does this firstborn have to do?"
但是雅各觉得长子的名分最重要，我暂时那这个汤不要喝，我能够得到这个最好，所以这个就是他的信心。
But Jacob considered the firstborn status more important than his red suit, and that was his faith.
那我们今天来看，我为什么信耶稣
？And so reflect upon ourselves today. Why do I believe in Jesus?
真的很多的人虽然信耶稣他对神的恩典还是停留在那一碗红豆汤。
And for many believers, their faith in God is still on that bowl of red soup.
为什么
？Why？
我要靠耶稣让我书读好。
I believe in Jesus so He can help me academically.
我靠耶稣找好工作。
And I rely on Jesus to get a good job.
我靠耶稣钱赚多一点。
And relying on Jesus to earn more money.
我靠耶稣生活舒服一点。
I rely on Jesus to have a better standard of living.
那这个所有靠耶稣得来的福分，都是今生上、肉体上、物质上。
But these blessings are all things that pertain to this world.
那什么叫做真正信耶稣里面的宝贵
？So what is the true treasure of believing in Jesus?
信耶稣的宝贵就是我们能够以神做我们的产业。
So the true treasure in believing in Jesus is that we can have God as our inheritance.
追求神的同在。
We can strive for the abidance of God.
使我们活着今生内心非常的丰盛。
So that when we are living our life, in our heart we live in abundance.
充满着平安跟喜乐。
We're filled with joy and peace.
我们死了以后到天国。
And when we pass away, we enter into heaven.
我们能够在天国享受永远的福分。
And we can enjoy an everlasting blessings in heaven.
这个才是信主真正的价值。
And that is the true value of believing in Jesus.
当然，这些肉体今生神也会给我们，但这不是最有价值的。
Of course, when we believe in Jesus, Jesus will also give us blessings that has to the worldly blessings, but that's not the most important thing.
看得见是暂时的。
Whatever we can see is only temporary.
看不见是永远的。
Whatever we cannot see lasts longer.
所以信心就是我们能够抓住神应许给我们的永远看不见的福分，全力以赴去追求。
So to have faith is to strive forward for the things that we cannot see.
好，所以以扫在讲雅各骗他两次。
So Esau said Jacob deceived him two times.
第一次就是因为雅各有信心。
The first time was actually because Jacob had faith.
他把握这个机会，他得到长子的名分。
He grabbed hold of the opportunity and he gained the firstborn status.
但是问题是第二次。
But the problem comes the second time.
第二次就是怎么真的得到长子的名分。
The second time is how he actually gained the firstborn.
如果我们回到创世纪二十七章。
If we look into Book of Genesis, chapter 27.
这个创世纪二十七章就在讲以扫第一节。
In verse 1.
请。
Chapter 27, verse 1. Now it came to pass when Isaac was old and his eyes were so dim that he could not see, that he called Esau his older son and said to him, My son. And he answered him, Here I am.
第三节。
Verse 3. Now therefore, please take your weapons, your quiver and your bow, and go out to the field and hunt game for me.
第四节。
Verse 4. And make me savory food, such as I love, and bring it to me that I may eat, that my soul may bless you before I die.
所以以扫他要死以前他就要为以扫要死以前要来祝福这个以扫。
So before Isaac was about to die, he wanted to bless Esau.
因为本来他是长子。
Because Esau was the firstborn.
但是我们如果从二十七章再读下去，
But if we continue reading chapter 27,
雅各就用欺骗的方式来得到他父亲给他的祝福。
Jacob got this blessing through deception.
那为什么雅各会用欺骗的方式来得到这个祝福？
And why did Jacob deceive his father to gain this blessing?
如果我们回到27章，
If we look at chapter 27,
是他母亲给他的建议。
This was an idea given to him by his mother.
我们先来看回到创世纪的二十七章。
Let's turn back to Genesis chapter 27.
第八节。
Verse 8.
请。
Now therefore, my son, obey my voice according to what I command you.
这个第八节就是利百加他也听到了，所以他就告诉雅各怎么用方法去欺骗你爸爸来祝福你。
And because Rebecca heard what Isaac said, so she now then tell Jacob to do certain things.
那这个雅各也有一点害怕，如果我爸爸听出来我不是以扫，我是雅各，那咒诅我怎么办？
And Jacob was actually afraid. He was afraid that his father will find out, and he might get cursed instead. Let's look at verse 13. But his mother said to him, Let your curse be on me, my son. Only obey my voice and go get them for me.
这个十三节，母亲跟他讲咒诅归到我身上。
Here in verse 13, his mother said, Let your curse be on me.
那祝福你的咒诅归到我身上。
The blessing will go to you, and if there is a curse, it will go on me.
所以他的妈妈教他用欺骗的方法得到祝福。
So his mother taught him to deceive his father to gain the blessing.
所以雅各就照着这样去做。
And then Jacob obeyed.
得到他父亲的祝福。
And he received his father's blessing.
但是从那一天开始，他哥哥就想要杀他。
But starting from that day, his brother wanted to kill him.
为什么雅各要搬家？
So why did Jacob need to flee?
因为他做了一件错误的事。
Because he did something wrong.
当然这也出于他对长子名分的信心。
But this was also out of his faith in the status of firstborn.
只是他做的方法是不对的。
It's just that the way he went about doing it was wrong.
那为什么他会这样做？是因为他母亲对他的建议。
And why did he do this? It was because his mother told him to do that.
所以现在他要开始搬家。
So now he needed to move.
啊，所以这个让我们知道，我们父母对子女的爱。
So we can see, the love that parents have for their children.
最保险的爱就是用主耶稣的爱来爱我们的子女。
The most conservative love, is to love our children with the love of Jesus.
因为这是最正确的方法。
Because this is the most correct method.
那如果我们用主的爱来爱我们的下一代。
If we love our children with the love of Jesus.
我们下一代一定蒙福了。
Then our next generation will be surely blessed.
所以圣经在讲啊，为什么神要祝福以撒、雅各，都提到亚伯拉罕。
And so why does, when God wants to bless Jacob and Isaac, He always mentioned Abraham.
甚至亚伯拉罕死了好几百年了，圣经说神纪念亚伯拉罕，就祝福他的后代。
Even after hundreds of years that Abraham has passed, the Bible still says that because God remembered Abraham, and so God blesses descendants.
因此有时候我们给下一代如果一个错误的建议，让他做了错误的决定他的人生就要付代价。
Therefore, if we were to give wrong advice to our children and they follow that wrong advice, then they will have to pay the consequence.
那这个对跟错到最后还是要回到神的观点来看是对还是错，因为每个人都觉得自己是对的。
And whether something is right or wrong, we have to go back to the Bible and see it from God's perspective because everyone thinks that they are correct.
所以属灵人看透万事。
Therefore, a spiritual person can see through many things.
那谁是属灵的人？
And who's a spiritual person?
就是他有基督的心。
Is someone who has the heart of Jesus.
这个就是我们在追求的目标。
And that is a goal that we need to pursue.
有基督的心。
To have the heart of Christ.
用基督的心来带领我们的家庭。
And to guide our family with this heart of Christ.
让他们能够蒙福。
So that they can be blessed.
所以我们如果人生方向有偏我们下一代有时候会受苦。
If our direction is straight, then our next generation will suffer.
那我们回到28章。
Let's turn back to chapter 28.
那雅各要离开别示巴。
So,
是第十节。
In verse 10, Jacob went out from Beersheba.
我们想想看，如果我们是雅各。
So, imagine if we're Jacob.
你要离开最爱你的妈妈。
You're going to leave your mother who loves you the most.
不晓得什么时候会再见到她。
And you don't know when you'll ever see her again.
你要离开。祝福你的爸爸。
And you're going to leave your father who blessed you.
不晓得什么时候可以再回来见到他。
And you don't know when you can come back to see him again.
要离开那个想要杀你的哥哥。
And you're leaving the brother who wants to kill you.
不晓得以后再回来他哥哥是不是会杀他。
And you don't know if by the time you come back if he still wants to kill you.
所以雅各在这个旷野里面我们可以想到他对前途真的是茫茫啊。
And you can imagine when Jacob was in this desert, he feels lost.
然后他的非常的孤单。
And he was very lonely.
在这个时候神向他显现。
But at that moment, God appeared to him.
所以我们每一个人的一生有时候都会遇到像雅各这个情况。
So throughout our life, we might encounter, a point where we're like Jacob.
离开我们最爱的家人。
Where we've left our family members,
或者最爱的家人离开我们
，or our family members left us,
或者家庭没有办法和睦
，or that there's no harmony in the family.
我们处在痛苦当中
，and we're living and we're suffering.
那在这个时候，谁能够真正给我们安慰
？And at this point, who can truly comfort us?
谁能够真正给我们盼望？
And who can truly give us this hope?
谁能够真正应许他可以带领我们前面的路
？And who can truly promise to guide us our future?
只有一个，就是天上的神。
And there's only one who is the God in heaven.
又真又活的神。
Who is true and living God?
所以人生经历很多的苦难之后
，So after we have faced many suffering in our life,
我们回头过来看
，And if we turn back and look.
我们就发现人生最值得依靠的一位就是天上的神。
will see that the one who's most reliable is the God in heaven.
所以二十八章我们刚刚所读的雅各睡醒了，16节说神真的在这里，我竟然不知道。
So as we've read in chapter 28, verse 16, then when Jacob awoke from his sleep, he said, "Surely the Lord is in this place, and I did not know."
我们今天不论走到哪里。
And today, no matter where we are in our life,
我们在受洗的时候，我们就跟神立约。
When we were baptized, we made this covenant with God.
虽然有时候我们做了一些错误的决定。
Even though we might have made some wrong decisions,
但是神不会离开我们。
But God will not leave us.
我们最怕的是我们自己离开了神。
What we should fear the most is if we leave God.
我们只要都愿意回头，神都愿意来接纳我们。
If we're willing to turn back, God is always wanting to accept us again.
所以这个二十八章在雅各要面对将来人生要怎么变化，没有办法掌握的时候，神将他显现。
So in chapter 28, when Jacob didn't know about his future, God appeared to him.
那雅各到年纪大的时候，他回头过来看。
And when Jacob was old, he looked back on his life.
他怎么看他的人生？
And how did he view it?
我们现在看创世纪。
Let's look at Genesis.
47章。
Chapter 47.
创世纪的47章。
Genesis chapter 47,
第九节
verse 9. And Jacob said to Pharaoh, "The days of the years of my pilgrimage are 130 years. Few and evil have been the days of the years of my life, and they have not attained to the days of the years of the life of my fathers in the days of their pilgrimage."
这个第九节雅各对法老说，我在世上寄居是130岁。
Here Jacob said to Pharaoh, "The days of the years of my pilgrimage are 130 years."
那130岁里面是什么
？And what's within this 130 years?
是又少又苦。
They were few and evil.
那不及我在列祖寄居的日子。
And they were not as long as his father's days.
那如果我们看到47章的27节。
If we continue to look at chapter 28,
雅各活了147岁。
Verse 28, Jacob lived 147 years.
所以在他死的前17年，他讲我的一生又苦又短。
So 17 years before he died, he said, "My life was short and evil."
那如果我们再仔细回头过来看这些苦有时候不是神要给他的，是他自己的错误所造成的。
And so if you look at the bitterness that he encountered in his life, some of it is not that God wanted to give it to him, but it was the consequences of his wrong.
那这一条路他必须走。
And that was the path he had to walk down.
对他的人生是一种熬炼。
It was a training for his life.
神没有说你不需要走，但是神说我要跟你同在。
God didn't say, "You don't need to walk on this path," but rather God said, "I will abide with you."
所以后来雅各到拉班的家里面受很多的苦。
And so when Jacob went to Laban's house, he suffered.
为了娶一个太太做苦工14年。
And in order to marry the wife he wanted to marry, he labored for 14 years.
然后后来这个拉班想办法改了他的工价。
And afterwards, his uncle Laban tried to change his wage several times.
本来要叫他空手回去的，但是神显现，所以到最后他可以带一些东西回来。
And originally, Laban wanted to send Jacob away empty-handed, but God appeared and stopped that.
神真的与他同在。
And God was truly with Jacob.
神真的带他回来。
And God led Jacob back.
但是在这一个期间他经过很多的磨练。
But during the process, Jacob really had a lot of training and suffered.
那我们现在再看创世纪48章15节。
Let's now turn to Genesis chapter 48, verse 15.
48章的15节。
Chapter 48, verse 15. And he blessed Joseph and said, "God, before whom my fathers Abraham and Isaac walked, the God who has fed me all my life long to this day."
这个十五节 雅各就对约瑟祝福。
And in verse 15, Jacob blessed Joseph.
然后他提到一生牧养我直到今天的神。
And he mentioned the God who has fed me all my life long to this day.
所以虽然一生经历这么多的苦难但是神一生在牧养他，神没有离开他。
And even though in his life he labored and toiled, God did not leave him. God fed him.
所以我们不晓得我们前面的路要怎么走。
So even though we don't know about how we're going to walk our path in the future.
但是有一件事情我们要确定。
But there's one thing we need to be sure of.
如果神跟我们同在。
If God is with us.
不管我们有没有犯了什么错误。
It doesn't matter if we have committed any wrong or not.
只要我们愿意回头归向神。
As long as we're willing to turn back towards God,
神会一生继续带领我们。
God will lead our life for our whole life.
回到他所应许给我们的这一块地。
And he will guide us back to the promised land.
我们一生回头过来看，我们会发现神的恩典是满满的。
And when we look back on our life, we'll realize all the blessings and grace God has given us.
他是牧养我们一生的神。
He is a God who has fed us and guided us all our life.
人生的第一件要务就是要追求神的同在。
And the first thing that we need to prioritize in our life is to have the abidance of God.
唱诗。
Let's sing him.
234.
234.